On Wednesday, we received news of a new variant, the so-called Omicron variant, and I want to express my deep gratitude to scientists in South Africa who identified this new variant and shared the information widely and immediately. This variant is spreading around the world, with two cases so far identified here in the UK. As always, I must stress this, with a new variant, there are many things that we just cannot know at this early stage. But our scientists are learning more hour by hour. And it does appear that Omicron spreads very rapidly and can be spread between people who are double vaccinated. There is also a very extensive mutation, which means it diverges quite significantly from previous configurations of the virus. And as a result, it might, at least in part, reduce the protection of our vaccines over time. So we need to take targeted and proportionate measures now as a precaution while we find out more. And first, we need to slow down the seeding of this variant in our country. We need to buy time for our scientists to understand exactly what we're dealing with, and for us to get more people vaccinated, and above all, to get more people boosted, as well as to help our NHS prepare in what is already a challenging winter. So yesterday we took steps to protect the UK against the variant coming here from southern African countries, and earlier today added four more countries to the red list. But we now need to go further and implement a proportionate testing regime for arrivals from across the whole world. So we're not going to stop people travelling. I want to stress that. We're not going to stop people travelling, but we will require anyone who enters the UK to take a PCR test by the end of the second day after their arrival and to self-isolate until they have a negative result. Second, we need to slow down the spread of this variant here in the UK, because measures at the border can only ever minimise and delay the arrival of a new variant rather than stop it altogether. So in addition to the measures we're already taking to locate those who've been in countries of concern over the last 10 days, we will require all contacts of those who test positive with a suspected case of Omicron to self-isolate for 10 days, regardless of your vaccination status. We will also go further in asking all of you to help contain the spread of this variant by tightening up the rules on face coverings in shops and on public transport. And third, and most importantly, we need to bolster our protections against this new variant. We don't yet exactly know how effective our vaccines will be against Omicron, but we have good reasons for believing they will provide at least some measure of protection. And if you're boosted, your response is likely to be stronger. So it's more vital than ever that people get their jabs and we get those boosters into arms as fast as possible. So from today, we're going to boost the booster campaign. We're already planning to do 6 million jabs in England alone over the next 3 weeks. And now we're looking to go further. So the Health Secretary has asked the JCVI, the Joint Committee on Vaccination and Immunisation, to consider giving boosters to as wide a group as possible, as well as reducing the gap between your second dose and your booster. And of course, we're speaking to our counterparts in the devolved administrations and we'll continue to coordinate with them. The measures that we're taking today, including on our borders and on face masks, are temporary and precautionary, and we will review them in 3 weeks. At that point, we should have much greater information about the continuing effectiveness of our vaccines. I very much hope that we will find that we continue to be in a strong position and we can lift these measures again. But right now, this is the responsible course of action to slow down the seeding and the spread of this new variant and to maximise our defences so that we protect the gains we've worked for so hard and so that we can continue to save lives. Thank you. I'm going to ask Chris to do the slides.
Thank you much, Prime Minister. First slide, please. We thought it was sensible to start
off. Joining me now to discuss this, what you just heard from the British Prime Minister Boris Johnson there, talking about this new variant that is causing kind of global fears, a lot of new travel restrictions. We've got Nada Bashir in London, Nick Valencia in Atlanta, David McKenzie in Johannesburg, and Arlette Sines traveling with President Biden. We also have Dr. Esther Chu with us as well. She's a professor of emergency medicine at the Oregon Health and Science University. Nada, I want to start with you about what we just heard from the British Prime Minister. They are saying that there are still a lot of unknowns about this variant, but he said that it is something that they learned about on Wednesday, and he thanked those scientists in South Africa for notifying other nations of it so quickly.
That's right. He did thank South Africa, and there has been some pushback there with regard to the travel restrictions the WHO has said that it may have been a hasty decision. But clearly, the UK government is taking this very seriously, imposing these restrictions and taking action quite urgently. But we have just heard some pretty stark warnings, although there is still some unknowns around this new variant. The warnings we've heard from Boris Johnson are concerning, to say the least. He said that there is evidence to suggest that this variant does spread rapidly and can spread among those who are double vaccinated. And that is, of course, going to be a key point of concern. And it might reduce the effectiveness of these vaccines over time. But we have just heard that there will be these national measures now coming into force in addition to the travel restrictions. Of course, the travel restrictions are coming just as the UK was beginning to open up its borders, you know, allowing people to travel with a bit more relaxed rules as opposed to what we've seen in previous months. But now the UK will be taking more stringent measures at its borders, requiring people to take a PCR test on arrival and to isolate until they receive that negative test result. So that is coming into force to stem the spread of this new variant. Of course, hearing now that it may be more transmissible, but there will also be those national measures, and there have been calls. I mean, we've seen other European countries taking on those stricter national measures as we've seen in the past, countries including Austria and Slovakia taking on that full lockdown, the Netherlands a partial lockdown. Now, Boris Johnson has just said that these measures will be temporary. They will be reviewed at 3 weeks, and we're not going so far as a lockdown in the UK just yet. But what he has said is that there will be tougher measures. They will be asking people to wear face masks in shops and on public transport, although many people still do that in the UK. And they will be requiring all contacts of those who test positive to isolate for at least 10 days. So there is going to be a revision of the measures that are in place at the moment. But of course, Boris Johnson has just stressed these will be temporary measures as part of efforts to really stem the spread of this new variant. They will be reviewed at 3 weeks, but as we move into the winter months, the focus will really be on the impact this variant will have on hospitalizations in the UK and, of course, across Europe. We saw with previous variants, particularly the Alpha variant last winter, which had a huge impact on these hospitalization rates. Of course, that will be a major focus in the next few weeks. Caitlin?
And Dr. Chu, I want to get your take on what we heard from Prime Minister Johnson there, because there are a lot of things that we do not know about this. And that is what U.S. health officials have been stressing, that it's not clear if the concerns over this new variant are justified yet. And he said that literally scientists are learning about this hour by hour. But he did say that they believe it spreads rapidly, that it can be spread by people who are double vaccinated. And also, of course, what we had heard from Dr. Fauci, which is that there is extensive mutation when it comes to this variant.
We need to do some watchful waiting. It's too early to panic. It looks like there's early information about transmissibility. But the other thing that makes variants of concern is if they cause more disease and more severe disease, and if they evade our immune protections from vaccines, and to what extent. And of course, from the hospital perspective, we're really concerned about that disease severity potential, because we actually haven't recovered fully from the last surge in the fall. And so hospitals are really struggling to keep up. If this ends up causing more disease, more severe disease, causing hospitalizations, that could be really devastating around the world, really emphasizes the vulnerability we have in under-vaccinating much of the world.